5 levels and 5 stages of procurement challenges, and we'll tell you what to do in each step. So today we're using bean bags, and I've got a box, and Abby's got a bucket. But in the house you can just have a pair of socks, and you can just have your bin, or anything like, or a pillow that they have a sock to throw onto.
Okay, so a few tips for throwing, these would be our top tips. So you want to make sure that we're balanced. So want everyone to have a look and see where their feet are. And if they're shoulder width apart, you're stable. If you're in close, then you might wobble and it might go off. So want everyone to be shoulder width apart. So I'm gonna have a look and see if they're shoulder width apart. Okay, boys and girls, so I want you to put your target on the floor. And I want you to stand with 2 feet in front of the target, and you're going to take 4, 5, or 4 steps back. Like that there. So then there's this between you, okay? And then from then, you're going to try and throw your ball or your stock or whatever into the target. And then that's one. And then if you get about 3 or 4 stocks or whatever and have a go, and you can get all of them in, then you go to level 2. So I'm going to go back, pick that one up, start again, so that's me, got all of my socks or bean bags in, so then I can go up to level 2.
So another wee top tip for throwing is we're going to bend our knees slightly, and because of the next challenge we're going to be further back, so bend your knees and you're just throwing off that shoulder width apart like this. Okay, so then for challenge 2, for the first challenge we were 5 steps back, so this time to another 5. Now we're much further back. And now we're just going to be doing the same. So what do you have to do when you're throwing? Yeah, that's right. So feet shoulder width apart, bending your knees, and just releasing the shoulder width. So let's try. And we'll try one more time. Yep, that's super well done. Now on the challenge 3.
So our third challenge, boys and girls, would be balancing. So we're just going to give you some top tips on how to keep yourself balanced. So I want you to keep the cord really tight, and I want you to bend your knee a little and just lift your foot slightly. But keep the cord tight, and then you'll not be bobbing all over the place. Just like the first one, we'll be doing 5 steps. So I want everyone to count their 5 steps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I want you to get on your left leg and get your right leg off the ground, making sure that you keep your core tight. And we're just doing the same thing, we're just following through into the box. And we'll have another video. Okay, so another wee top tip for everyone. We're going to be using our right leg, which is the other foot this time. Another wee top tip is if you're feeling a wee bit unbalanced, keep your arms out. And if that doesn't help, try and find a space on the floor and just focus on that space, and that might help. Okay, so this is challenge 4, and we're going to be using our right leg. So I want everyone to be going up and taking their 5 steps back. And you're on your right leg, your knees slightly bent, and your arms out and feeling a wee bit wobbly. And using your sock to strand it into the target. So everyone, let's have a go. this is our final challenge, which is challenge 5. So we will be taking another 5 seconds back. And this time we're going to be a bit harder, and I want everyone to turn around. And you're going to try and throw without looking at the bucket and trying to get into the bucket. Alright? So everyone have a go. So that's all the challenges done. Feel free to make it a wee bit easy if you need to. Come a wee bit closer. Find an object to hold on to, but we hope you enjoy all the challenges.
Well done. Bye.